Welcome back. Today video session we are going to talk about how to create a web application. The past video session I have shown so many examples. Those examples I used RESTful web services. The RESTful web services I used get mapping. Using get mapping I showed all those examples, right? But I never showed how to create a web application. In this video we are going to talk about how to create a web application. Okay. Go to spring.io. In the spring.io I have already added com.it garden. Then this is first web app demo using Spring Boot. Then package name com.it garden web. Then dependency. I have to for web services and web application we need to add one dependency is web. This web is this web dependency used for to create a RESTful web services as well as a Spring MVC based web application. Okay. Now this our Spring Boot application now support to create a RESTful web services as well as Spring MVC web based application. Now I want to add some UI part, right? Add some UI part. For that there is another dependency called timelift. Timelift is a template engine. Using timelift we can integrate our backend controller. Whatever data returned by the controller, that data we can display in our HTML page. This is the use of timelift. Once you add the timelift, automatically your Spring Boot application do the auto configuration to show all the data coming from backend. Okay, now I have added whatever I need to create a web application. I have prepared with one simple example. It's a web controller. In previous example we have seen displaying the HTML page, how to display HTML page. Now in this example we'll see that how to post the data to the server, how to receive the data from the server through the web application. Okay, for that I need to use post and get mapping. Okay, in the web app controller there is a one method called course submit. It's a get mapping. Whenever call this particular method, I want to initialize a new course. I want to map this course object to in my HTML page. That HTML page name is a post.html. When you look at post.html page, here inside a form object there is a three different input box. I want to map this entire form object to the course object. For that we have to see th. There is a one tag called timelift tag th:object. In this HTML page we are using timelift tags. Through that tag we are integrating our Java object to the HTML page. The form object we can pass one attribute called th:object equal to $course. This $course nothing but this particular course. This course key is a model dot add attribute of, we have to pass two arguments. One is a key name, another one is a which object you want to pass. I want to pass course object. The course object key name is a course. Now that key name we have to mention here in the form level. Now in that meaning the course object mapped with that form. Inside a form there's a input box, that each input box we need to map with the field. Map with the properties, course properties. In the course properties we have a three properties: course name, place and duration. Course name, place and duration. In the post.html page the input text field I'm mapping that object property to in the input box. Th field equal to course name, th field equal to duration, th field equal to place. This is the syntax to map your Java object property to your input box. Then finally I am submitting. When I submit, what will happen? It will submit the data to the server. Submit the data to the server. Okay. Now, how do we submit the data to the server? There is an action. There is an action attribute from the time leaf, th colon action. All time leaf attributes start with prefix with th. Th colon action equal to at the rate of display. I want to call display method from the backend. What is the display method here? This is a display method. The display method mapped to one method called, sorry, the display mapping. This we have to call it as a mapping. Okay, I wrongly named it as a method. This is a display is a mapping. This mapping available in the web controller. This mapping mapped with a one method, right? Let's see that display mapping mapped with one method called display course. That display course having one attribute, one argument called model attribute. Don't have this model attribute followed by course. This model attribute mapped with the course object. Okay, course object through this model attribute annotation. Whenever you say submit, whenever click that submit, it will go to here. It will go to here. Whatever value typed in this input box, that value available in the course object. That value available in the course object. Whenever you submit this method execute, this line will print. This is displaying the course detail. Whatever name you typed in input box, that value display here. Course name, course duration, get place. Everything display here. After that, I returning display. What is display? Display is again a HTML page. Through post method, I am filling some value and submitting. Once submitted that, this method will execute. That value again will be printing. Then I am redirecting to display.html. That time what I am doing here, the display.html, I am printing that value, whatever I am typing, course name, course duration, course place. Okay, here whatever object you are using here, the course, that same object you have to use the HTML. Course.course name, course.duration, course.place. Now everything will print here. Then after printing, there is a hstf tag. In the hstf tag, I am redirecting to post HTML. When I click this particular link, it will go to again here. Then I can type something and submit, then it display. So through this example, I am doing two kind of operation. One is post. Through this post method, I am displaying the post form, post.html, where I am filling the data. The post.html, when I submit, I am calling this display action. It is displaying all the data. Okay, this is a simple example. Through this demo, I am showing how to display the form, how to fill the form object, how to submit the form object, then how to display the data from the form object. Two examples showing part of this demo. Apart from that, redirect. After displaying through this href, I am redirecting to post.html. Again, you can fill some data. Now we will go to the demo. In the get mapping method, I am opening the post.html page. That's the reason I am giving post. It might be a little bit confusing for you guys. This is not a post mapping, this is a get mapping where I will going to displaying the post.html file. Okay, now we'll see the demo. To access the post.html page, we need to use this URL. Whenever call this URL, it will call this course submit method. The inside a course submit method, I am initializing the course object. That course object mapped with one key called course. This key value we have to use in the post.html file. Okay, that I have already shown. See, post.html showed here. I'll go to type a course name. Spring Boot, duration 40 days, place Chennai. While submit this particular button, it will call this display method. It will call this sorry, call the display mapping and call the display course method, and whatever I am typing here, that value get printed here. Okay, now we'll see here. Submit. Submitted. Once submitted, since I am calling display, the display.html getting invoked and displaying all the name. All the name. Spring Boot, duration, for this place, channel. Okay. While submitting, I am printing this information the server side. So that's the reason here all the data printing here. Spring Boot, duration, 40 days, place, channel. Okay. I am clearing this now. After submitting, displaying this page, when I click this submit another course, it will open a post.html. Why? Because in the display.html, you can see here I am redirecting to post action. I am redirecting to post action. When I click this, it will go to post.html. I mean, when you click this, it will go to server, invoke this method, display this statement, and again mapping this course object to this particular page. Correct? Okay, I'm going to create the console. Submit another course. See here, display the course form. Here it's, I'm mentioning display the course form. I'm printing that. I'm mapping that course object to the pof.html. pof.html, pof.html. Then it will printing here. Okay, again I can say here some course Kafka, duration 10 days, channel. The console, when I say submit, it will display in page as well as in console I am displaying the information. Okay, now this is the demo, but apart from demo, I want to give some instructions. When you exercise this particular demo, you have to be careful with the names. For example, the pof.html, in the form level, I am using course. This course must be matched with this course. This course must be matched with this course. If you say, I am going to say one. Now in the pof.html I am saying when just a course. Let's see what's happening. Server started successfully. Now I'm going to invoke the pof.html post action. It's not printing whitable error page. The server side I am getting some error. Neither binding result nor plain target object for bean name course available as request attribute. Otherwise, in the course, the timely expecting the course object, that the course object available in the course key, but that is not available, not binded with the course key, because I am mentioning here course 1. Okay, that is the reason it is giving the error. So be careful. If you use this name, the same name you need to use your form object, the form page. Okay, another one is while displaying I am saying at model attribute, then which object you want to display, course and a course object name, course class and a course object name. Then in the display page I am using here course.course name, course.duration, course.place name. Why I am using course here? I am not at all using anything word course in this HTML page, but still I am using course. The reason is the web.controller, the object name is course. Okay, that same name should use here, otherwise it will not work. Okay, I'm going to change here some other name called data. You can change that name like this, data. Okay. Now, the same course object I am using here, but you will not get printed that value, because the model attribute I am using key as a data. Through this key only we need to use. Let's see what's happening. Server is started now. I am going to say post. Now post will work because I am using course as well as here also course. So it should work. I am going to say Java, core Java, 40 days, then Chennai. See, nothing is printing, it is giving the error. Reason, in the web.controller, I am using model attribute of data. This data key mapped with the course object, mapped with the course object. So, your time limit expect this word. In the HTML page, we need to use this one data.courseName, data.placename. Now I'll go into restart and see. So we started now. I'll go into save post. Code Java, what it is, then Chennai. Now it's printing. Okay, because in the display.html I'm using data.courseName, data.duration, data.place. These are key to access the attributes. That key should mention in model attribute argument. Okay. These are the points you need to remember. You may do some mistake by doing the small mistake, you may spend a lot of time. That is the reason I am explaining these things. I hope you understand how to create a web application in a Spring Boot using Timelif. I will not explain more example now, but I will going to focus only REST web services. Because most of the companies are using only web services. Using Spring Boot, they are not at all going to create, they are not at all creating the web application. Okay, everything going to be a web service now. That's the reason I want to focus only web service. If you have any other specific requirement, if you have any help, please comment me. Definitely, I will help you out part of the web application. Okay. Next class, we are going to start a web service, RESTful web service. I have committed this example in my GitHub repository. I have given in the link in the description section. Please download and use it. Until then, bye bye from Suraj Keshavan. If you like this video, please like it. Please share with your friends. Please share this video to people who want to learn Spring Cloud and Spring Boot in detail.